Cool.
Hi, I'm Cedric, and I'm a uni student. Or some people might like to call it a bottom feeder. Hi, I'm Cedric, I'm a bottom feeder. In my last semester of uni, I took up a computer vision module. And it was a bad decision, it totally killed my GPA. But it did help me to make this video. Enjoy. Have you ever wondered, how do I do a markerless AR overlay? Neither have I. Well, we have education to thank for that. Speaking of education, one of my friends asked me this question during the semester. Cedric, I can't believe that one bet can turn the whole world upside down. To which I reply, oh, it's because bets are always upside down, right? If you haven't guessed, I'm quite proud about what I said. Okay, well, enough with the chit-chat. Roll the clip. First things first, you gotta pick an image for your markerless overlay. I recommend that you take out your wallet, smash it, and pick a random card. That's what I did. Wow! Great! So now that you have picked your image, you want to go to your computer and upload it. Home! Hey, wait. How did that happen? Next up, you just gotta run some Python code and there, you're done! Look at you! A true computer vision expert!
Using the OpenCV library, we first set our chosen image and detect unique points on the image. Next, the program matches these points to whatever is captured on your computer's video frame. If the unique points are detected, the program will overlay an image of your choice at the exact coordinates.
And if that was too hard to understand, just remember it as spaghetti computer magic.
Sorry, I just had to. Now, you might be thinking, Cedric, this is an amazing project. How could it possibly hurt your GPA? Well, this is what happened.
Good afternoon, Prof and fellow classmates. Showcasing this project, Prof, to answer a quiz. A journalist asked a programmer, what makes your job bad? No comment. If you're wondering, my prof really did throw a box at me. He threw an empty box that was meant for bottled water. It was really funny at the time. He probably got a good kick out of it too. So contrary to what I mentioned in the video, this project is actually really simple by industry standards. Nothing too complex. But the code was really hard to find and it took me forever. So yeah, just thought to make something out of it. I'll be linking the project down below. If you like what you saw, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. But I guess I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Wait! Oops, I realized I didn't explain the joke. So if you're not a programmer, you're gonna be so losted. Losted is like the past tense of lost, but even more lost because you're lost in the past. So, comments. Comments in Python are written after a hash sign. Like the name suggests, you'll be using normal language to explain, label, footnote, your code. For example, in the video, I wrote kill me to express how I felt about writing this code. Basically, it doesn't affect the code at all. It's literally to explain the code. Without comments, it's actually really difficult to understand what your code does. Cause you're not the only programmer. Other people gotta read your code too. You cynical, uncultured prick. Just kidding. Joke, 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 joke. And if you don't leave comments, your code's gonna be bad. Never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down.